Fall.
Fall. Fall. Jolie
Jolet.
fall.
Jolie.
Jolie fall. Jolie fall.
What up, champions? Happy Wine Wednesday. It's Vinolog number 3 with Work in the Weekend. We're going to be drinking another rosé today.
Last week, we drank, as we always do. We tested a rosé, and not all tests come out positive.
I decided that I wanted to introduce Travis to a rosé that I've liked for a long time. What makes a rosé a rosé? I know that some of them have red wine grapes, but do they just stop it halfway through? Mm. Or do they mix white and red grapes? Like, how does that work?
Well, think about how people get color. You get color when you go out in the sun. The longer you're out in the sun, the more color you get.
Okay.
Wine works in a very similar way. When you want red wine, you take red grapes, you crush them, you let them sit for a long time so that the color from the skin of the grape mixes in with the juice of the grape.
Okay.
And then you get a color. Like red. When you want a rosé, you just do that for a shorter amount of time.
So they take the skins out, or they just, it's not fermented, or essentially it's not aged as long as red wine. It's a shorter process than red wine, which makes it not as dark.
I guess back to the suntan analogy, it's all about how long you're in the sun.
Okay.
It's all about how long you, the juice, is touching the skin of the grape.
Wait, so is it like maybe the younger grapes? They still are on the vine the same amount of time.
Yeah, same grape.
Okay. Okay, so break down the process. Like, how does it, do you know how it works?
One, you harvest the grapes. You take them off the vine. Two, you wash and destem them. Three, you gotta crush the grapes so the juice comes out.
Is that like stomping? Like when you see people with wine stomp, like on Lucy? I Love Lucy.
Do you remember that YouTube video?
Oh, 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 oh.
Step four, this is where you actually kind of squeeze out the juice and put it into a different container. So step five, this is where the fermentation happens. But step six, they'll actually mix some to get the right color.
Is this like a hired consultant, a color consultant, or is it the actual winemaker? Because I would love to be a rosé color consultant. I feel like the lighter ones are more refreshing, except the one we had last week.
Well, how was your eyesight?
I mean, I have to wear glasses when I watch TV or I'm on the computer.
What color is this shirt?
Navy.
Okay, you're fine.
Okay.
You're hired.
So today we're drinking another French rosé, Jolie Fall. If you say in French, it means crazy beautiful.
How do you pronounce this?
I think it's Jolie Fall. Flair. I don't know how to say the second word.
I'm going to toss another name in the hat. Tell me how you feel about it. Jolly Folly. Can we just call it Jolly Folly? I mean, look at it. That's Jolly Folly. Should we open it?
Sure.
I don't use that.
Well, I like it.
Well, I use this.
So let me tell you something, you're doing it wrong already.
What do you mean
so whenever
wrong?
I wait at table,
I'm about to open it.
The label to the guest at all times, and you move your hand only. You're twisting the bottle around, that's not proper.
I'm trying to be proper. Did you hear
it? Too loud.
Now what do you do with this? You take this off, right?
It's their choice whether they'd like to smell it or not. I'm not really into that, but I'll do it. It's like whatever. I'll just smell it in the glass. Ooh.
It smells like wood. Hey, fun fact, do you ever notice these are imprinted with the name of the winemaker? Way back in the day, thieves would steal the wine, pull out the cork, dump out the good wine, put into a bottle of their own, put in some crappy wine, some very, very cheap wine,
sell
and
it?
Put in a generic cork and then resell it. To ensure that this wine comes from this maker is to put that maker's mark.
Oh, so maybe that's also why they give corks, so you can kind of check it out. Okay, cool. Well, let's smell this bad boy for real.
Could be rumors. Let's go you first.
Okay, let me bring back my service days. Sir?
Yeah, that's what I saw 2 minutes ago. It's the same bottle. Some bubbles in there.
Okay, so for me, it smells super light, and it almost smells like a Jolly Rancher.
Jolly Folly.
Cheers. It's better than I imagined.
Yeah, you've had it before.
I know, but I couldn't remember how it tasted. I just knew I liked it. So you said you smelled watermelon. Do you taste it too?
No.
I feel like I get watermelon. I feel like I get a little kiwi, maybe grapefruit too.
I know with this, you're expected to taste watermelon, strawberry, white fruit?
White peach.
White peach. You ever seen a white peach?
Mm-hmm.
What?
Yeah.
I feel like I can smell with wine. I can't taste with wine. It's kind of like a mosh pit. I can tell you whether or not one guy was hitting me or 20 guys are hitting me. That's the complexity of it. But I can't tell you who hit me. I can't pick out the flavors.
So, long story short then, do you like it?
Okay, so here's the best test. Would you buy it again? Here's a bottle, you've tasted it. Would you order it at a restaurant?
Yeah, for sure. I actually might stock up for days when I'm dreaming of summer when it gets a little colder out. I guess that concludes our tasting today. Thanks for tuning into Wine Wednesday, and we'll see you next time.